All right, thank you. Because I'm half American, I think I get wheeled out here to tell you just how bad things can get. And I've got to say, I spent 11 years in Louisiana, where we had second lines, but they were for real dead people. I was very touched when earlier on they were talking about the executions that were carried out right here, because of course I've watched six of my clients get executed, and it's not a great idea. Now, first I want to tell you, having lived in America for so many years, one thing that bemuses me about Great Britain is you people just don't know how good you've got it. It really pisses me off when I go to the NHS, for example, and hear those morons bad-mouthing the NHS. Because frankly, when you go to the US, you need health insurance because you won't have any health care. You need travel insurance because you will get held up at gunpoint. I've been held up 7 times myself. Just a little word of advice for you. When they point a gun at you, the first time it didn't go very well for me. But after that, I got good, and these guys pointed a gun at me, and I said, look, I'm a defense lawyer. Why don't you go mug a fucking prosecutor, because you're going to need me one day. And the third thing you need when you go to the United States is you need death penalty insurance, because they're going to give you some lawyer who's paid sub-minimum wages to do a crap job for you. Lest you don't believe me, when I first tried a capital case in Louisiana, they paid us $1,000 to do what, for me, I keep my timesheets all the time, it was a little over 1,000 hours, so it was 99 cents an hour they paid us to defend people for their lives. And we sued them under the federal minimum wage law, saying you've got to pay us $5.25 because that's what you pay at McDonald's. That's how bad it can get. In the last 20 years, I've spent suing in America to gradually get legal aid a little bit better. And to see what's happening here is immensely depressing. But don't lose heart, because if there was ever a group of cowards, it's some of those politicians over there. What I love is they're afraid of us, whereas we don't give a shit about them, frankly. And when, you know, I want to just give you a little advice from our American experience, and I want to work with you on this. First, you've got to know who your jury is. I don't know why some of you are meeting that moron, Grayling. I wouldn't waste my time, because he's only tinkering with the machinery of death. He's not interested in doing anything about justice. The people who are our allies are some of the people over here in the Lords, the Labour Party, the Lib Dems, and some Tories, some libertarian Tories who understand justice. And we've got to focus on them. And when we focus on them, we've got to persuade them, not frankly with the issue of how much lawyers get paid. I'm afraid that's not an argument that goes down terribly well with the public. But there are so many arguments that do. And you've got to tell the stories about the human beings who are going to get screwed over. Right now, we're representing Abdul Hakim Belhaj, who was the guy that the British rendered to Libya so he could be tortured by Gaddafi, right? One of the amendments in this whole bill is to take away legal aid for people who we as British people torture abroad so far away that they can't get any help. Those stories about what they're trying to cover up and the nasty things that they're trying to do over there, those are the stories. And you've got so many stories, and you've got to tell those stories. Don't just sign petitions, tell the stories. The other thing you've got to do is you've got to mess with them where they least like it. I have a plan for a bunch of students to come out of the Thames dressed as James Bond across over near MI6 to go screw with those people so all the journalists have some pictures to take. And one thing we did in Guantanamo Bay was we came out with orange underpants when they tried to arrest me for supposedly smuggling knickers into one of my clients, which I didn't do, by the way. But we came out with orange underpants that said, "Fair trial my ass" on the back. And everyone wore them all around. And I think you'd look good in orange agent provocateur underwear with little shackles on the front. It's not sincerity sometimes or sanctimony that persuades. It's humor very often. It's also, those people don't like to be laughed at. You need to laugh at Grayling, because what he's doing is asinine, and it's exactly the opposite of what we should all do. So let's get together in the pub, come up with some fun things we can do to fuck those people over, and I will enjoy coming along with you to do it. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Clive Stafford Smith.